Hi everybody, just a tiny video today with some quick thoughts. I remember watching on YouTube a few years back a segment from The View, and word to the wise, by the way, don't watch The View. Do not try this at home. I watched this particular segment so that you don't have to. Sometimes I take one for the team. And the guest was Suzanne Venker, who, needless to say, is a braver woman than I shall ever be for going on The View in the first place. And as she attempted to explain for the panel where it was, in her estimation, that feminism really went wrong, Whoopi Goldberg, I think it was, turned to Joy Behar. I'm not 100% certain of all their names, but she whispered something like, she doesn't know, she wasn't there, or she wasn't brought up that way, something like that. And the sentiment that she was expressing is one which we anti-feminists encounter quite a bit from women who do call themselves feminists. This idea that you weren't around in the 60s and 70s, you don't know what it was like, and everyone applauds like that's a valid point because they have no choice. No, I wasn't. I did not experience the world prior to second wave feminism. Just like second wave feminists never experienced the world when the suffragettes were operating like domestic terrorists, but second wave feminists spoke of their noble cause, women's suffrage, as if they witnessed that firsthand. But you know who was around in the 60s and 70s and 40s and much earlier? Phyllis Schlafly, who got into politics and wrote books and went to law school in a time when feminists tell us that women couldn't do such things for they were all chained to the kitchen. Or what about Margaret Thatcher, who had no time for feminism and said, "I owe nothing to women's lib." She denied that she had any responsibility whatsoever to promote women within government just because she was a woman. And Lord Hurd, who was quite close to her as I understand it, said that wasn't her job, for heaven's sake. She wanted to appoint the best people. The novelty. Or what about women like Grace Goodwin, who was an anti-suffragist and wrote articles for the paper, which were published, about why women do not desire the vote and why our feminist sisters do not speak for us. Yes, there were anti-suffragists, organized women who opposed women's suffrage, just as there are anti-feminists today. But I bet you didn't learn that in your history book when you were learning about women's suffrage and feminism in general. Or women like Susan LaFleche, who was a Native American woman and became a doctor in 1889, becoming the first Native American woman to earn a medical degree. My point is, if you really go back in history and you take a comprehensive look at it instead of a one-sided look, remember history is written by the victors, and the victors in this case have been feminists, you will see that it wasn't as one-sided as we've been led to believe. Women who were willing to work hard and break the mold very often did so in an age when we're told there was no equal opportunity. In reality, it's just that such women were few and far between, and of course we are constantly bombarded in our media and our culture with this lie that equal opportunity really looks like equal outcome, and if you don't have the same number of male nurses and you don't have the same number of female engineers as male engineers, then we are still living in a totally sexist society. Of course, in order to hold this view, you have to entirely pitch biology, science, psychology, and sociology out the window. And then my other point is that for as long as there has been feminism, there have been women who have opposed it. And you can hate on independent thinking women, you can condescend to them, you can chalk up their conclusions to internalized misogyny, which is a way to really just invalidate a person's opinions right away, or you can take a good, hard, honest look at the things that anti-feminists are saying and at history. Do an honest study about where feminism really came from, what its purposes really were and still are, and then make your own conclusions. Granted, it's hard to research past the narrative that is everywhere. It's hard to find resources and historical documents that aren't taught in schools, but they are out there, and the perspectives that they offer on gender relations down through the decades in our culture, in our country, is very different than the mainstream. Well, this has just been some food for thought, and I hope you have a great day.